population. So in earlier days, a computer was very big and it required a lot of space and maintenance cost was more. So we'll see the evolution of computers first. Hello everyone, welcome to Study Time. In this video, we are going to see Class 4 Computer Chapter 1 Computer History. This is KV or CBSE based syllabus. In Class 3, we have learned about the basics of computer, its strength and weakness. We learned how to start and shut down computer properly. We also learned do's and don'ts in computer lab. I'll give the link in the description box. Please go through the video so that you'll be understanding Class 4 computer easily. In this video, we are going to see how computer evolved, various generation of computers and their classification. The computer we see has not invented at once. It has been evolved a lot for the last couple of decades. Decades is more 10 years. Before computer, we used fingers, grains, stones to do simple calculations. After that, manual calculators were invented to do simple calculations. In earlier days, a computer was very big and it required a lot of space and maintenance cost also more. So, let's begin evolution of computers. In the evolution of computers, we are going to see three various eras. That is manual era. First, we are going to see evolution of computers. There are three eras in evolution of computer. First one is manual era, mechanical era and electronic era. First, we are going to see abacus. Abacus is a device that allows the user to represent numbers by the position of beads on the track. Simple addition and subtraction were carried out rapidly and effectively by positioning the beads on the rack. So based on these position of the beads only, they calculated addition and subtraction. Even in modern period, we use abacus for fast calculations. Next is cardboard multiplication calculator. This is another manual calculating device to speed up the multiplication process. Here you can see in the picture, it consists of rods. These rods are called as bones. Each represents the digit 0 to 9. So based on these rods only, they calculated multiplication. Called as bones. So each bones contains digit from 0 to 9. They used repetitive addition to carry the multiplication process in this method. Next, we are going to see mechanical era. So in mechanical era, the first mechanical calculator was developed and it was like this as given in the picture. Next, Pascal developed another mechanical adding machine called Pascaline, where it was used to add and subtract numbers. This Pascaline machine, so this is a Pascaline calculator where it used gears and wheels. Using those gears and wheels, they added and subtracted numbers. Next is similar mechanical calculator was developed. So this calculator performed multiplication and division. So previously Pascaline performed addition and subtraction. Here this mechanical calculator performed multiplication and division. Next we are going to see Charles Babbage invention. Who is called the father of modern digital computers? Yes, it is Charles Babbage. He designed a differential engine in the year 1822. So it was able to perform automatic multi-step calculation and can produce reliable mathematical and statistical tables automatically. Then he had a new idea of analytical engine that was intended to be completely automatic. It was capable of performing the basic arithmetic functions for any mathematical problem at a very high speed. So these analytical engine had many features like internal memory, and it has got one arithmetic unit to perform calculations. So here in this era, Augusta Lovelace was the first programmer of the world. Next we are going to see punched card. So this is punched card tabulating machine, where it is used for processing census data. Next is Bell relay computers. These computers were developed in Bell telephone laboratories. So it was able to perform calculations with a high speed and accuracy. Next we are going to see automatic sequence control calculator. Mark I computer, the world's first generic purpose mechanical digital computer, was developed by Howard H. Aiken. So its design was based on the technique of punched card machinery. So this machine is called automatic sequence controlled calculator. Next we are going to see electronic era. So electronic era has got the first electronic computer using vacuum tubes. So it is used 45 vacuum tubes for internal logic and capacitors for storage. Next, these computers are called as ABC computer and were capable of solving variables with a high degree of accuracy. So electronic computers were high degree of accuracy. Next what evolved is electronic numeral integrator and calculator, that is ENIAC. So it was the first large scale fully electronic computer installed at Maryland. Next we are going to see what is electronic discrete variable automatic calculator. So it stores both instructions and data in the binary form. So this is the difference between ENIAC and EDVAC computers. Next we are going to see what is electronic delay storage automatic calculator. So it was capable of performing addition in 1500 microseconds and our multiplication operation in 4000 microseconds. Next is the universal automatic computer was first designed by many it is the first digital computer produced by many companies like IBM, Universal Accounting Company, General Electronic Corporation. It was the first commercial large-scale digital computer produced in 1951. Then later, during the period of 1940s and early 1950s, many other stored computers were evolved, like JOHNIAC, ILIAC were also developed. Next, we are going to see generation of computers. What are the generations evolved in the computers? So there are main five generations. We are going to see one by one. So what are the difference between first generation and second generation, advantages and disadvantages, all those details we are going to see. So this is the technology used in 5 generations. So first generation they used vacuum tube, second generation they used transistors, third generation they used integrated circuit based, and fourth generation they used VLSI, and fifth generation they used ULSI. We'll see that one by one in detail now. First generation computers. The computers of this generation used electronic valves. So these electronic valves are array of vacuum tubes. So these are the basic component for memory and circuitry for central processing unit. These vacuum tubes were a fragile glass device like electric bulb. So they were very expensive and could be afforded only by very large organization, and they produce lot of heat and it causes frequent fusing or damaging of the installations. So this is very huge and it occupies more space. First generation computers occupies more space. So the period is 1942 to 1955. Component used, already we saw it is vacuum tubes. Next is speed is milliseconds. Maximum memory capacity is 2000 inch. Mean time before failure, so the time taken to recover from failure is minutes. Peripherals here is input output peripherals is punch card, paper tape, magnetic tape, printer, etc. Next, secondary storage is punched cards, paper tape, magnetic drum, magnetic disc. Next, operating system is mainly batch processing. Language is used is machine code and electric wire board. Application areas is payroll processing and record keeping. So example of these first generation computers are ENIAC, EDWARC, HSAC and IBM 650. Next we are going to see what are the advantages and disadvantages of these first generation computers. These computers were the fastest calculating device of their time. So when compared to that generation computers, it is the fastest calculating device. Vacuum tube technology made possible the advent of electronic digital computers. But what are the disadvantages? Already I told, it is very big in size. Air condition is required to control the temperature because it produces more heat. It falls, the frequent hardware failure happens in this first generation computers. Commercial production was difficult and costly because it is very huge and cost wise it is more. So commercial production was difficult. Slow input and output operations. So these are the disadvantages of first generation computers. Next we are going to see second generation computers. Already I told you, second generation computer used semiconductor transistor instead of vacuum tubes. So these generation computers used transistors, which were cheaper, consumed less power, more compact in size, more reliable and faster than the first generation computers. So when compared to first generation, it was more reliable. Next we are going to see useful points in this. So period is 1955 to 1964. Component used is transistors. Speed is microseconds. Maximum memory capacity is 128,000 inch. Mean time before failure is days. Peripherals is paper tape, magnetic tape, visual display unit. Secondary storage is paper tape, magnetic drum, magnetic disc. Next, operating system is multi-programming, time sharing and real-time processing. Languages used are assembly language, high-level languages like Fortran, COBOL, etc. Next, applications areas, they are used in billing, payroll processing, updating inventory. Example of these type of computers is IBM series. So you can see IBM series and CDC series. Next, we are going to see advantages and disadvantages of second generation computers. Advantages is smaller in size when compared to first generation computers. They are more reliable. They generated less heat when compared to first generation computers. Less prone to hardware failure. Wider commercial use. These are the advantages. Next, we are going to see disadvantages. Here also, it produces more heat and air conditioning is required. Manual assembly of individual components into functioning unit was a very difficult task. So these are the disadvantages and advantages of second generation computers. Next, we are going to see third generation computers. These generation computers used integrated circuits or IC chips, in which many transistors, resistors, capacitors and other components are integrated and packed together into a very small surface of silicon known as chips. This new microelectronic technology was called as integrated circuits. So you can see in the picture, they are called as IC chips. Next, period is 1964 to 1975. Component used already we saw is IC. Speed is nanoseconds. Maximum memory capacity is 4 million inch. Mean time before failure is weeks to months. Peripherals is input-output peripherals is typewriter terminal, visual display unit, optical character reader, secondary storage is magnetic disk, extended core storage, mass storage devices. Next, operating system, multi-programming, time-sharing, real-time processing and remote processing. Languages is high-level languages like Fortran, COBOL, BASIC, ALGOL, PASCAL. Next, application areas. They were used in airline systems, marketing forecasting, credit card billing. So, example of these type of computers is IBM 360 or 370 series and ICL PDP 11 RCA Spectra 70. So, these are the examples of this type of computers. Next, we are going to see advantages and disadvantages of third generation computers. They were much smaller in size as compared to previous generation, more reliable than second generation computers, low maintenance cost, easily portable, commercial production was easier and cheaper. Next, we are going to see the disadvantages. The disadvantages is the same air conditioning is required, highly sophisticated technology required for the manufacture of IC chips. So these are the disadvantages of third generation computers. Next, we are going to see fourth generation computers. Initially, integrated circuits contained only about 10 to 20 components called small scale integration, that is SSI. Later, medium scale integration was developed, where they integrated up to 100 components in a single chip. So next, after that, they incorporated thousands of active components in a single chip. They were called as large scale or very large scale integration, that is VLSI. So SSI, small scale integration, MSI, medium scale integration. So in small scale, they used 10 to 20 components. Medium scale integration, they used 100 components minimum. And in very large scale or large scale VLSI, they used hundreds of thousands active components on a chip. So the first microprocessor Intel consisted of 2250 transistors on a microprocessor. It was a 4-bit microprocessor. Next, we are going to see the important points in fourth generation computers. The period is 1975 onwards. Component used are very large scale integrated circuits. Speed is picoseconds. maximum memory capacity is 200 million inch. Mean time before failure is months. Peripherals used here is input unit is input output unit is visual display unit, optical character reader, magnetic ink character reader, voice recognition, laser printer. Secondary storage is floppy disk, hard disk, CD-ROM, DVD. Next, operating systems where time sharing real time processor. Languages used where all high level languages like C, C++, Java. Next, they were used in mathematical modeling, electronic front transfer, computer aided manufacturing and design. So the example of these series, these generation computers are CRAY-1, CRAY-2, IBM series. Next, we are going to see what are the advantages of these generation computers. So, advantages of fourth generation computers are they are smaller in size because of high component density. Heat generated is negligible, much faster in computation than previous generations, less power consumption. No air conditioning is required in most cases because heat is less. Disadvantages is highly sophisticated technology is required for the manufacturing of VLSI chips. Highly skilled people are required in its manufacturing. These are the advantages and disadvantages of fourth generation computers. Next, we are going to see fifth generation computers. So that is from 1991 onwards. These are the generation that we these are the computers that we use now. They use ultra large scale integration chips instead of VLSI. These will be employing two or more processors which compute in parallel. The fifth generation machine are proposed to be based on parallel processing hardware and it has artificial intelligence with genuine IQ that provide the ability to reason logically and with real knowledge like human do. So this is the basic thing you need to know about fifth generation. So it has got artificial intelligence and it uses ultra large scale integration chips. So which has more components than VLSI. So what are the characteristics of these future generation computers is they are decreasing cost of hardware and software, high speed processing, knowledge based processing system, development of natural language processing, advancement in computer technology, supercomputer technology. So it has got artificial intelligence, think and behave like human. So it is not human, it is humanoid. We call them as humanoid. Next, we are going to see classification of computers. Depending upon the ways the data can be handled, computers are classified mainly into three categories. One is analog computers, digital computers and hybrid computers. What is analog computers? These computers are in which data or number is represented in the form of physical quantities, varying physical quantities like pressure, temperature, voltage, current. These computers measure things. So they are used in speedometer of a car. You can check temperature, so thermometer, gasoline pump. So these are the places where they use analog computers. Next, we are going to see digital computers. These computers solve problems by operating on discrete data, so representing variables by performing arithmetic and logical processes on data from a stored program. So these computers count things. Previous computer measure things. These computers count things. They are used in home, educational institutions, office, scientific field, businesses. Next, we are going to see hybrid computers. Hybrid computers are analog computers. They are controlled by digital computers instead of human beings. So these computers are used in hospitals, meteorology departments. So next we are going to see types of digital computers according to the purpose they are used for. So based on their purposes, it is classified into special purpose computers and general purpose computers. So what are these special purpose computers? They are designed to single specific task. The programs or instructions to carry out the specific task are permanently stored in the machine. So example, computers are billing counter, so in malls. So they are designed to do only single specific task which is permanently stored. Next is, what is general purpose computers? They are used to solve variety of problems having different set of inputs. Example, computers for banking, sales analysis. So here they use general purpose computers. Next we are going to see types of digital computers according to the size and performance. So based on the size and performance, they are classified into embedded computers, microcomputers, mini computers, mainframe computers, superframe computers. So what are these embedded computers? Embedded computers are designed to be used within the circuitry of appliances such as television, washing machine, refrigerator, bike. Here we use embedded computers. What are these microcomputers? These computers are designed to be used by single user for performing basic operations like educational activities, playing games. They are used in homes, office, shops, school, etc. Under microcomputers, it is again divided into three categories. One is personal digital assistants. So where we use these as notepads and address books. These are designed to carry out day-to-day tasks related to sharing or exchange of information by connecting to desktop computers irrespective of location. Next is, under this microcomputers you have laptop or desktop. They are used to carry out our day-to-day personal tasks. They are used in business and at home. What are these other types under microcomputers is workstations. So they are used in industries, business purposes. So under microcomputers you have personal assistant, laptop and workstations. Next comes mini computers. These are more powerful computers than microcomputers. They are generally multi-user systems. So next is mainframe computers. They are designed to handle large volumes of data and information. They are multi-user and multi-processor systems. Next is supercomputers. Supercomputers are designed to be used for doing extremely complicated computations that also in minimum possible time. So these computers are capable of doing extremely complicated computations in very less time. So they are the fastest, largest and more expensive digital computers available today. So they are used for weather forecasting, nuclear science, aerodynamic modeling. So in these places, these supercomputers are used. The example of supercomputers are Param series. So PARAM series computers come under supercomputers. So we saw what is embedded. So embedded is used within the circuitry of applications. Microcomputers, they are used for as personal digital assistants, laptop, workstations. Mini computers, they are more powerful and capable of doing multitasking, and they are multi-user systems. Mainframe computers, they are multi-user and multi-processor systems. Supercomputers, they are designed for doing extremely complicated computations, and they are the fastest, largest and most expensive digital computers. Next, we are going to see practice session. Name the first calculating device that you know, that is Abacus. Who is known as the father of digital computers? So, Charles Babbage. Who is the world first computer programmer? Already I told you, Augusta Lovelace. Next, name the technology or the basic component used in different generation of computers. So, first generation they used vacuum tube. Second generation they used transistors. Third generation they used IC. Fourth generation they used very large scale integrated microprocessor. Next, fifth generation is ULSI microprocessor. These are the technologies used in. Next, name any two supercomputers developed in India. One is Param series, another one is Super 301. You have different supercomputers developed in India. Just explore it. What is the basic difference between a digital computer and an analog computer? Analog computers measure things, whereas digital computers count things. Analog computers were used in speedometer, digital computers were used in home office uses. So these are the places where we use analog and digital computers. Next is expand the following. EXAC is electronic delay storage automatic calculator. UNIVAC is universal automatic computer. ENIAC is electronic numerical integrator and calculator. VLSI is very large scale integration. Next is AI stands for artificial intelligence. An ICU of a hospital has hybrid computer to monitor the heartbeat of a patient. Name the category of the computer that we generally use at home or in educational institution. So it is microcomputers. Hope you all clearly understood how computer evolved. We saw various generation of computers, its advantages, disadvantages. We saw many classification under computers. Hope this video is useful. Thanks for watching.